There's a swimming pool.
I just want a big deer to be on camera. That's all I want.
Well, I can see deer. This doesn't look like buck.
There's the elk. Same day, this, couple of...
This, I swear...
There's
this,
a bobcat.
I swear this elk is gonna be...
There's the bear that's pooping. There's another bear. There's three cubs. Look at that.
They're so cute.
Yeah, let's just not run into them. Okay, so
that's
we...
a big
turkey. Wow, we have quite the ecosystem around here. We have...
Look at that big turkey.
We have turkeys, we have bears, we have elk, we have deer, we have bobcats,
so
we have coyotes. Oh, there's a decent buck.
Well, there's a tree stand, and there's a scrape. That might be a little close, though. Saturday, September 25th, 4:30 right now, but I just passed a 10, a beautiful buck. I didn't even have time to get the video camera up on him. I got the second one that was with him. I don't know. He's standing in the exact same spot. That's where I shot my biggest buck. Not ready to be done yet, you know? There's not a ton on the camera. There's one really, really nice one. A lot of the deer on this property show up mid to late October. This is my favorite tree stand in the whole wide world. If I could only sit in one spot the rest of my life, it's a good spot. I think this is probably where we're gonna shoot our deer this year. Thank you. was going to come out to the open. He didn't. He just stayed in the brush. But he's a pretty nice buck. He's got nice tines. It's just not very wide. It's about 7:30, October 30th. This is the first year since 2016. Shot a deer before October 29th, but not too worried. It'll only be getting better the next 2-3 days. right then. He was gonna get in the stick stuff, he's gonna be gone. So I just took a chance, stood up. The does all started to run. He kind of looked around, and when I drew and settled, he turned and looked at me and locked. And I just rushed it. So it's been about 30 minutes since I shot him. I'm probably gonna get out in a couple of minutes and just look at the area where I shot him. We have news. It's bad news. So, as you can see, I have about this much penetration on the arrow. That's not gonna kill a deer. So what that tells me is I obviously clipped the elbow. I don't know what this is. There's no excuse for it. I rushed the shot terribly. And because of it, I don't have a buck. I don't like it. You know, he's obviously going to be hurting.
53. Through one blood. He's done so. There he is, right there. Drilled him, man.
But November 1st here in Wisconsin, we're in west central Wisconsin, kind of by La Crosse. And he shot me a nice 10 pointer this morning. It's been kind of a tough year, to be honest. We haven't seen nearly as many deer around as I usually do back in southern Wisconsin, especially. Up here, there was quite a few bucks around this year. Obviously, on Saturday morning, I blew it on a really nice buck, a pretty big 9-pointer. And then since then, it's been pretty tough. It's been kind of windy. Haven't seen a lot of deer movement. This morning, it was quite a bit colder, and I figured we'd have a pretty good chance, and didn't see anything until I don't even know what time it was. It was probably 8:30. This guy came through pushing two does. He walked down to my right at about, I don't know, 65. And then the does came up the hill, and he followed him up the hill, and he came and he stopped actually right in front of the camera there on the trail. It stood like a statue, and I just couldn't pass up the opportunity.